Hey guys, Andrew here, and today we're going to be playing Mighty Number 9. So when we last left off, we were trying to fight the final boss of the fucking game, and turns out that, the mistake was that the boss is actually not meant to be fought in a regular setting, because it's a terrible program designed and terrible executed boss. So, of course, I ran into a lot of issues. Thankfully, the game has a way to fix that, which is to alter the amount of lives remaining to 9. If you change it to 9, then you don't have to worry about it. You don't have to worry about shit. Like, look at that, I got 9 lives remaining. I'll never get a fucking game over again. And if I do, then this game is clearly fucking destroyed. If I can't beat the final boss in 9 lives, this game has failed. I don't think I've actually legitimately failed a fucking Dr. Wily stage since I was like a child. There's no way to fucking fail a Dr. There's just no way to fail a Dr. Wily stage. They're so easy. Let's see here. Oh my god, I almost died from that. Bring it on. Because somebody didn't want to fucking goddamn work the right way. So, here's the thing. I spent, I'm not gonna lie to you. I spent a bunch of time trying to see if there was a way I could cheat my way to victory. And when I say cheat my way to victory, I literally just mean I was trying to see if there was a way you could, not have to do this. In any capacity. What? That was weird. Okay. My conclusion turned out to be that there is no way to cheat your way to victory. As unfortunate as it sounds. Okay. That is too late. How will this work? Okay. Let's see. Good enough. Oh, saves. Here we go. Here we go. Yeah. As I was saying, sorry, I got distracted. I'm trying to fucking not fail. Yeah, so the way that I got around this was the way I was trying to get around it was to literally cheat my way to victory, which did not work as you might expect it not to, because as it turns out, this game is actually not that incompetent. They weren't so incompetent that they literally allow you to break the game, but I did find an invincibility glitch from clearly an old build of the game, which was nice, but
Beck. With Beck.
Fucking plot in this game. If you're gonna be generous and call it that. Okay. Nice, clear. Alright. It's not really as hard once you know how the gimmick works. Ow. Thank you. Oh shit. Hey. Alright, there we go. That wasn't that bad of a hike to get back to the boss level, but I'll tell you what. It's not... Oops. There we go. It's not a fun one. That's for sure. It's definitely not a fun hike. So apparently I was right when I did this. I checked online. This is the weakness. Sticking a drill in its ass is about as good as it gets, apparently, with this game. So, let's see here. So, basically, I should be able to do this without any fucking problems, theoretically. Just have to keep on trucking, basically. Oh, I fucked up. What a waste of energy that was. Yep, so basically, it's just this forever, theoretically. Oops. Ah, that's what I was... I was like, wait, something's wrong here. I should be able to hit it. Cool. Boom, look how fast that was. Wasn't that amazingly fast? Wowie zowies, I wasn't ready for it, Andrew. Are you a savant at the game? No! No! I just understand how to play now. Oopsie daisies. The only thing that kind of sucks is that sometimes this ability doesn't really work the way you like it to. Because it's dumb. Oh shit. Oops, it easies. Alright. Oh, God. So now the problem is to... There we go. Wow, look how much better I'm doing. Oh, God. Ow. I'm not a fan of this. What the fuck is this move? What the fuck is this move? You can't even hurt her during this phase, apparently. Fantastic level design. Oh, right. I thought she was going to be ready to assimilate. Ah, so close. It's okay, I'll just do it 8 more fucking times. How bad could it be? Andrew, you're probably being too brazen there. No, I wasn't actually. I was being about the exact level of fierceness you need to be. Also, there is no other abilities that are worth using on her, apparently. Apparently, this is the only ability that's going to actually do a substantial enough amount of damage. It's going to be noticeable. So, you know, that's fun times right there. But who am I to judge a game? I didn't make it, and I can't make games, because I'm just a guy who plays games. I don't make them, so I don't have any right to tell designers how to make their games. Oh, I fucked that up. I fucked this up pretty bad. I need a health pack, but I'm not going to get one, because the game actually actively refuses to give you one. Because reasons. Oops. Yeah, the game actively tries to avoid giving you health packs and lives as much as possible. It tries to always assume, no, it's just because you're not doing enough damage. Yeah, that's what it is. Oh, you're not doing enough damage, Andrew. When you start doing more damage, then you'll be okay. You just gotta do more damage. Got him. Great. Love watching halfway in-game cutscenes where you have to kind of wait a little bit and the boss comes. So I tried figuring out, like, what are the other ways to do this boss fight? Are there multiples? Can I do it besides this thing? Because while that's nice and all, I'd rather not. Oh, no, wait. What happened? How did I take damage? What the fuck? Yeah, here's the thing. It's like you can't block any of those moves either. There's no way. Literally no way. To stop those moves from happening. You cannot stop that. You cannot block it. You just must endure and avoid. But by avoidance, it means, oh, you're gonna be here a while. I hope you enjoy your fucking stay at goddamn badly optimized boss fight, Inc. Please don't hate us later when you realize that this fucking game was a waste of Kickstarter money. It was also an utterly large waste of everyone involved's time. And I think even the CEO himself actually feels like killing himself after looking at how poorly the reviews went for this game. Which would be a grand, grand idea. If only there was such a thing as a god, then he would take away this fucking utterance of pain that's been dished out and sold to people for some fucking reason. Legally, mind you. Yes, legally this game was allowed to be sold to people, and still is, even though it is an utter travesty against all nature. E.T. was a better developed game. I will stand by that stance. E.T. was literally a better developed game. And that's saying something. A goddamn game so many times thrown in the dumpster that there's a fucking landfill full of them. That's how fucking bad that game was. And this game is worse than it. How do you even do that? How do you make a game worse than fucking E.T.? I don't know, man. I played Alone in the Dark. Alone in the Dark was less of a bad game. Sonic games are less of a bad game than this. That's how mad I am at this. Sonic is a better game than this could ever hope to be. Sonic. I mean, like, Sonic Boom is a better game than this. Sonic fucking Unleashed is a better game than this. Fuck, man, even goddamn Sonic 06 is better than this. There's not a fucking game alive that could even compete with how fucking horrendously bad every single decision has been in this game. And you can argue till you're fucking blue in the face, but it doesn't change the fact it's a bad game. I mean, arguing is one thing, but like, you can't deny the wrong that you are. Like, you can't be like, nah, that's just your own opinion. It's not even an opinion at that rate. It's literally common fact. Like, everyone knows it's bad. You just don't want to accept it. It's a bad game, trust me. Oh. You like literally fell. Weird. Okay. I did not know you could fall. That's an interesting problem. Alright. But it's okay, guys. We'll get through this boss fight, and I will hate myself eternally for it. One day I'll find a way to kill myself. Alright. So that's the only thing I can't do. The devastating wall attack, which takes, mind you, far too long, and mind you, does way too much damage. It's one of those boss fight mechanics where it's to go, oh, you managed to get this far. You weren't supposed to, my friend. My bad. Let me fix that for you with a subtle but not well-designed fucking attack. You know, like those kind of you'd imagine seeing in, like, I don't even know what I'm trying to say anymore. Oh, shit. God, I didn't even notice that it was damaged that much again. Yeah, it's like something you'd imagine seeing in, like, an old, old game that had no concept of mechanics or anything like that. Oh, god damn it. Oh. Damn it. Oh, that was dumb. Yeah, it's like one of those old-style games. It's like, baby's first boss fight! I guess it has to one-shot you. If it doesn't have ability where it can one-shot you, it's not a good boss fight, you know? Why? Why did I get hit twice for that? I wasn't even inside of the boss. What the fuck is happening with this goddamn game? Oh, my bad. What? What? I'm already at half-life. The game, like, actively avoids giving you any kind of health packs. Two health packs would be great. Two? Two of them? One of them would be great, actually. Just one is all I need. Like, if I just had one health pack, I'd be able to beat this boss with no issues. No issues! 100%. 100% promise, no bamboozle, that if I had one health pack, I could beat this boss with no fucking issues. But the fact that the game utterly refuses to give you one, not only does it utterly refuse to give you one, but it actively avoids letting you hold on to them as if for some reason, somehow, that's going to actually destabilize the entire game itself. Like, the whole crux of the game would be destroyed if you were allowed to have... Oh my god. What? Wow, I wasted so much fucking time on that. Hey! Hey, game! When the fucking enemy's purple on the stem, I can go through it. Thanks, goodbye. No, robot. They will not give you, if you do on 9, they're like, no, it's too easy, you have 9 lives, you could do it, trust me. Oh, okay, my bad. I forgot there's, like, not mechanics in this game or anything like that, that maybe, you should still be willing to give the player, because they, worked hard enough to earn them. I feel like the player kinda deserves them. Maybe I'm wrong, maybe the player doesn't deserve it. Maybe the player deserves nothing. Maybe all you get is a fucking sack of potatoes and a slap to the face, and you're supposed to be fucking happy about that. I mean, you got your fucking slap to the face of potatoes, what the fuck more do you want? What, you want fucking health? Fuck you! This is not a fucking game! This is a fucking experiment to see how fucking willing people are to give over money for fucking nostalgic trips and seeing how much they- and how quickly they'll regret it after getting the fucking full game. Turns out the experiment was a fucking utter failure. Everyone fucking hated it before they even had access to the game. Oh god, this is going terrible. Go ahead and shut it all down. Shut it all fucking down. There we go. Look at that. It's the most I ever got to this boss fight with. No, that's a lie, actually. I got to the first time I played, I got to the boss fight without getting hit once to the second stage. And I still died. Isn't that amazing? I had full fucking health, and I still died. I wonder why that is. Maybe because you need a health pack. Maybe a health pack is actually vitally necessary to beat this fucking boss. And there, I'm sure there's people out there because they spent hours and years and decades and their entire fucking adult lives doing it. And they're like, no! You don't need a health pack to beat it! I beat it just fine without one! Thank you very much! You're just a bad player! You need to get better at the game! Or not. I could literally not. Oh, I got hit doing that. Oh, I'm out of this. Oh, shit. Ah, shit. Oh, God. Come on. There we go. There we go. Nailed it. Oh, God. Nice. I might actually be able to beat it this time. It's because I'm constantly... Because the fucking heart of the cards is within me. Because I have the heart of the cards. Come on, Yu-Gi-Oh! I did it? Wait, I did it? I did... Oh. Oh my god, I was about to fucking lose my mind if that didn't count. I was like, no 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 no. That health bar is zero. I almost killed myself though, thinking that I have to do it again. Whew. Ugh, god. My brain, my heart, my soul, everything wants to be dead. I haven't felt this way in a long time. But I do know this. Mighty Number 9 is a terrible fucking game. -5 out of 10. You actually owe me my life back. Take your life and give it back. Give it to mine. You owe it to me.
Your true form. I did it. I mean, you did it, Trinity. We did it.
Excellent work, Beck. Excellent. You have surpassed even my greatest expectations.
Warning. All cells in the area are no longer under Trinity's control. They are destabilizing.
She means that the whole place is coming down!
The assimilation threat is gone. Mighty Numbers, rescue Beck and Trinity.
Roger that!
Yay. Oh, look, it's all of us. The day has been saved, thanks to Beck. Of course, she must be Ugu Anime Girl. There is no other way. She could, I mean, her original form was looking pretty okay to me. I thought that was pretty cool. Oh. Now we're doing battle bots or whatever. Cool. Seems kind of worthless given that I just literally saved the planet. But that's okay. Or the United States of America, I'm sorry. Saved America. But you know, whatever, that's okay. So yeah, that's Mighty Number 9. Oh boy! End-game wrap-up as we usually do. So, Andrew. Thank you, Andrew. What could possibly be better about Mighty Number 9? Literally anything. Just choose. Choose whatever you want. It could be better. Everything could be better. Oh, okay. Well, that was a dumb question, Andrew. I'm sorry. What do you think needs the most work on? Oh, okay. If I was to wager a guess, what would need the most work on? I'm thinking like it needs to work on not existing. It needs to work on erasing itself from history in every conceivable fashion. Even so far as to just, like, maybe just wipe it from history books. I would say almost we should do a worldwide effort to just not acknowledge that this person actually made a thing. All these people in the credits, they don't deserve any credit because they did nothing. They did nothing but shovel out shit to you. They shoveled out shit, and that's not okay. Because here's the thing. No one should remember the shit shovelers. Everyone should remember the people who made great things. That's how it should work. No one should be remembered for the shit that they sold to people after stealing their money, basically. Yes. If I was to give any actual real criticism, I would say Mighty No. 9, maybe it'd be best to replay all 9 games of Mega Man. And go ahead and tell me what you learned from that. You'd probably learn a couple of things. One is that a character designer probably should not be leading a game. Secondly, the other thing you'd probably learn is that all of the characters or all of the fights in Mega Man are actually fun and enjoyable and interesting. One of the most important things being the health bar ratio was actually a really important thing. Another one was the fact that calls and tells were very easy to notice in a SNES version of Mega Man. And yeah, they had limited pixels to work with too. By the way, they had a lot less pixels to work with, but somehow the fights were a lot more enjoyable and weren't nearly as hard as they were in Mighty No. 9. Another thing, too, is your type specification built, or your type versus weakness chart, which I've seen the flow chart now, is awful as fuck. The only obvious one I would come to the conclusion about would obviously be fire and ice. The rest of them? I don't even know how you got there, sir. You must have just been a fucking idiot. So, yeah, those type differences are not good. They're not good. You should probably rework that whole thing. If it doesn't work out, like if you can't really think of a logical reason why that would beat that, maybe get rid of it. The nice thing about Mega Man was that they literally just came up with what the fuck they wanted. You know, like Bubble Man and Electric Man. I think there was even like a Whale Man. I don't even know, man. There's a lot of mans. But let me tell you this. A lot of them made sense. Some of them in the later Mega Mans didn't make sense. I'll admit that. Some of them were shit. But guess what? The first Mega Man made fucking sense. I understood completely. I, as a bright young boy being handed a NES for the first time, was able to easily grasp the concept of Mega Man and beat it in probably about a month. I mean, I didn't say it was amazing, but, you know, I'm a kid. I can fucking... God, Mega Man's a hard fucking game when you're a kid. It takes a lot of patience and platforming skills and shit. But regardless, I had fun, and it was a challenge, and I felt like the game was teaching me stuff, and I just wasn't putting it to practice. Mighty No. 9 does none of that. In fact, Mighty No. 9 doesn't teach you anything, and it doesn't put any of that shit that it teaches you in the tips section into practice. Because here's the thing. You unlock a bunch of abilities, and it tells you, hey, you should probably absorb people based on their color when using other abilities. Like, if someone's red, use the red ability, which, I don't know, maybe it's pyro, maybe it's scissors. They're both red, technically. One's orange, one's red. You can't really tell the difference. In any case, you absorb them, and then... What? And then... I'm sorry, you didn't finish your sentence. And then what? You should do that! Okay. For more points? Yeah, for more points! Hey, I don't know if you knew this or not, but actually no one really gives a fucking shit about points in a Mega Man game. I just wanted to let you know. Like, when you beat the game in Mega Man, no one actually sits there and goes like, holy shit, look at that, I have the highest score of all time. I'm the fucking best Mega Man player in the entire world. No, see, that's the entire purpose of speedrunning. Speedrunning exists in Mega Man universes because it's actually a challenge and it's actually a test of skill. With Mighty No. 9, getting the best score is literally a superfluous act. It's actually even more superfluous of a stat to even show me at the end of the screen. I don't give a flying fuck what grade you think I deserve for beating that level. This isn't fucking Sonic. It's not about like, ah, you didn't kill enough people, you got hit too much and you weren't fast enough. Okay, but I beat it, so what the fuck's your deal? Why you gotta be salty about it? Who the fuck cares what the rating is for it? A rating is just some really shitty arbitrary thing you put in there to make players want to get better. I don't want to get better at Mighty No. 9, I want to get over Mighty No. 9. This is the whole fucking problem with your game. People don't want to actually become better at it. They want to just get the fucking thing over with so they don't have to play it ever again. Like, God. Oh, my number nine. Were there anything you did good? I don't know, man. Was there anything you ever did good? Was there, like, literally anything that was good? What is this? My number... What? Search? Oh, search the names. Holy shit. How many people? 9999999. Oh, that's not one? Well, how about 9,000? That's not one either. You didn't have 9,000 people donate? Come on, man. Why did you even give me that option then? God, yeah, that... If there's anything I'd say Mighty Number 9 did good, is that it looks good. That's about it. It looks good physically. I mean, sure, it's pretty graphics. It's kind of a fucking clusterfuck of a mess half the time when you're fighting enemies and colors have to change and all. Just make them blow up like they do in the Mega Mans. Jesus, I don't want to have to absorb people. It's fucking annoying. But, I mean, it looks fine when you're doing it. Doesn't look like some kind of indie project that was tossed out in a fucking 6 months or something. It doesn't look as bad as fucking Ark does with its shitty ass, like, nothing really looks like it belongs assets or Rust or one of those other early access indie games. They all look like poopy butthole shitholes. But, I mean, at least Mighty No. 9 looked polished. Played like it was fucking never... It was played like it was designed by people who never played video games before, but it was it definitely looked okay, so the art designer apparently knew how to be an artist. Good job. Good fucking job being able to do your one goddamn job, which is to fucking draw and to render things. Good job, man. Proud of you. 100%. You want claps? You're not gonna get claps, because you fucking... If you had all that free time after rendering all the fucking animations, maybe you should have gone over and just started stabbing the rest of your fucking programming co-workers. Specifically, the guy who was in director seat. Whoever was the director, the producer, and the publisher. You should probably stab all of them. Immediately. With all your swords. With all your knives. With all your kitchenware. With all your plates. With all of your keyboards. And with all of your shivs and shanks and pins and staplers. Just kill them. Kill them all. We don't need them anymore. They've contributed nothing to society. In fact, they've taken so much from us already. Just get rid of them. Yeah, I think that's about it that Mighty No. 9 did well. I would say my least favorite thing about Mighty No. 9... The fact that it's legally allowed to be sold. That's probably the worst part. My favorite part of Mighty No. 9 is the fact that... everyone else also mostly felt it was a fucking piece of shit, so there'll never be another one. And the knowledge that there will never be another Mighty No. 9 is, like, really great. I feel amazing about that. Like, the fact that Mighty No. 9 2 will never happen is good. It's what it should be. There should never be another Mighty No. 9 game. Ever. Like, particularly ever, specifically ever, theoretically ever, and ergonomically ever. There should just never be another fucking Mighty No. 9 game. Holy shit, I don't even care. I don't even give a fuck if they sold the goddamn rights to Capcom, and Capcom got every fucking person from the original Mega Man team back and put them in their exact original jobs, and then we're like, alright, team, go. No. Still no. Still would not trust Mighty No. 9 to be a good game. I still would think it would suck, actually. I bet you that fucking game would still suck, even if you put every single exact same person who worked on the original Mega Man in their same positions. It would still be a terrible game. Because Mighty No. 9 transcends bad design and bad developers and bad workers, employees. It actually is just a bad thing to the core. Kind of like, what's the word I'm looking for? It's kind of like a sociopath. Like, there's no redeeming part of a sociopath. They're just sociopath. Like, sure, they may, like, give you a flower or something, or they may give you a band-aid when you hurt yourself, but it doesn't change the fact they're still fucking sociopaths and feel nothing for that. They're just doing it because they're, like, on a fucking pre-programmed notion to do that. I was told, give band-aid, do injuries. Here's Band-Aid. Feel nothing about situation. That's how it fucking works. And you shouldn't feel bad about that. Because they're bad. That's not okay. It's bad. And that's how Mighty Number 9 is. Mighty Number 9 is a sociopath who gets no pleasure, no joy, no nothing. But takes from you everything. Takes all of that joy, all of that pleasure, all of that frustration, all of that. Every single emotion you have, Mighty Number 9 steals it from you. But it actually doesn't use or express it in any capacity. It's basically just like a fucking black hole of a husk. Steals everything from you, gives nothing to you in return. Holy shit, how fucking long is the goddamn credit section? Can I get to 10,000? Why did you even give me this option if there's not a fucking 10,000? They can't even fucking do that right. 9,000 doesn't exist. 900. Oh, we're already past 900. Wait, am I doing this wrong? Let me go exactly to 2,000. Can't go to 2,000. 2,100? 2,101? Okay, let me go to 3,000. Are you fucking kidding me here? How many backers are there? 3,000? There has to be 3,000 backers at least. I know there's more than 3,000 fucking back. Fine. 200, 900. This fucking thing doesn't even work! Skip all! Done with it! Holy shit! God damn!
Trinity was brought under control when she absorbed Beck's empathy and caring nature, his heart. My new synthetic heart routine makes it possible for robots to evolve ethically, to grow responsibly. Just wait. This will revolutionize the science of robotics, the fate of all robots, of all mankind.
You got lucky, that's all. And cleaning up your own mess doesn't make you a visionary. Besides, who can guarantee the behavior of robots left to their own devices, evolving on their own? This heart of yours is unnecessary, and worse, dangerous. I remain unconvinced, Bill.
Don't call me that. My name is William White. I'll show you. I'll show you and everyone else who doubted me.
Then only time will tell if this Mighty Number 9, this Beck, is a blessing or a curse.
New content in extra mode is here.
Oh good, a fucking boss rush has been unlocked. That's what I've always wanted. Shut the fuck up. Alright, well that's been Mighty Number 9. I apologize for having to put you all through that. I hope that we will never have to experience a game this traumatically awful again. Maybe we'll get close to another Sonic game someday, but never this fucking bad, I can assure you. Alright, well, after that I'm gonna go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you like what you see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me the worst Mighty Number 9 play you've ever seen before. And remember, it's not me. It's actually the game. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and bye!